With the Metal Uliphone launched a competitor to the Verny Tour, the phone is different from the Tour, especially in terms of the design, and due to that aims at offering a better price-performance ratio. Now, if this plan is a success, is something you will learn while watching this review. I am Christopher from China Mobile Mac, enjoy watching! So the Uliphone Metal comes in this black and slim box, which contains quite some stuff. There's an H6 tempered glass with oleophobic coating and a white flip cover which protects the phone well but kinda hides its beauty. Beauty? Yes, even a 120 bucks phone can be beautiful, and the Uliphone Metal is a clear proof for that. The handset is made from solid metal, which has been CNC crafted and thus looks and feels much more premium, like for example the Xiaomi Redmi 3. Build quality really is perfect, the handset is very sturdy, there are no moving parts and no gaps. The only plastic parts you will find on the Uliphone Metal are two antenna caps on the upper and lower area of the rear, as well as a thin plastic frame around the 2.5D screen glass on the front. Some critics we have are that the touch buttons are not backlit and that there is no status LED on the front. The SIM tray is a combo slot which can take either one nano and micro SIM or one nano SIM and a micro SD card. The 5-inch screen inside the Uliphone Metal looks nice. The picture is sharp and colors do look decent. Uliphone even uses an OGS panel which greatly improves outdoor readability. The resolution is 1280 by 720 pixels. The only thing we dislike is that you can see the conductor tracks of the digitizer a bit. The touch panel supports up to 5 touch points and reacts quite fast. It isn't good for fast typers though, since it isn't the most precise touch panel. We have been quite annoyed by hitting the wrong letters all the time. Also, the glass's surface could be more smooth and it does not feature an oleophobic coating like on the Verny Tour. The scratch test has been survived however, so we can't deny the Gorilla Glass 3 claim. Inside the Uliphone Metal we find a MTK6753 SoC at work supported by 3GB of RAM and 16GB memory. In benchmarks, the handset pretty much equals its competitor by Verny. Memory speeds are the same too. During everyday usage of the phone, we have never experienced performance issues. The system and all daily apps ran smooth, even while doing multitasking. Even games have been running flawlessly, but of course you will have to reduce graphics settings on current games to ensure they run smooth. We have been happy to see a magnetic field sensor inside the Uliphone Metal, however, excitement has quickly been replaced by disappointment when we tried multiple compass and navigation apps. The sensor simply does not work properly. The fingerprint scanner, however, has been working very well. It ain't the fastest one, but it is very reliable and has no issues with wet and oily fingers, which is decent. The Uliphone Metal runs Android 6.0 Marshmallow, which has been modified a bit in terms of the looks. The settings app has been modified the most. There are lots of additional features such as flip actions, off-screen gestures and an assistive touch feature, also known as the floating shortcut button that no one needs. Another feature we stumbled upon is a control for the screen's color temperature, which you can access directly from the screen settings without going through the MTK Mirror Vision setup. The operating system is well optimized and thus runs very smooth, not even a crowded notification center slows it down. There are two bugs which we have noticed. First one is the home screen which jumps back to the first page when you try to drag an icon on any page. Second is that the camera app doesn't save the video settings. If you set the quality to fine, it will be back to medium after a restart. Reception quality has been very good, the mobile network signal strength is great and we didn't face any issues with calls and web browsing even in trains. LTE band 20 is supported. The Wi-Fi reception quality is quite awesome, even one floor below the router we haven't noticed any significant speed drop. The GPS was working very well too, but we faced some issues with dropping accuracy when using it in the pocket. Another surprise was audio quality, especially the internal speaker. This one sounds very decent, it's loud, doesn't distort and offers a proper amount of bass. Which compared to the sound quality Xiaomi Redmi phones do offer. Via headphones, the audio quality is very nice as well, decently balanced and quite loud and clear. Even the phone call quality is decent, but you should expect issues with very loud environments since a noise cancelling mic. Camera sadly is where the Uliphone Metal sucks. Neither the front nor the main camera are very good at the moment. The main camera appears to be decent sensor wise, but it has serious issues with direct light, and we are not only talking about sunlight but also reflections and stuff like that. Due to this, most pictures look totally overexposed and thus awful. We will have to wait and see if this is some hardware problem or if Uliphone can fix this by updates. The front cam is not selfie capable. We also noticed a strange thing about the phone's energy consumption. function. Basically, the battery life is decent and the battery indeed is 3000 mAh in size. Reached 7.5 hours of screen on time in the PCMark battery benchmark. Reality does look different though. At least it does if you are traveling a lot. There is some bug which prevents the phone from going into deep sleep when looking for networks. This causes massive battery consumption on longer train or car rides. On a 4-hour train ride, we noticed a 60% battery drop, which is insane. So this bug really has to be fixed as soon as possible. Regarding charging, there is no fast charge. A full charge will take you around 3 hours. So in the end, we have to say that the Ulefone Metal, for its price tag, is a pretty decent phone, especially those of you who pick their phones by design and build quality but don't wanna spend a ton of money, find a pretty interesting device there. But the flawed battery life and the screwed up camera are serious downsides that Ulefone have to and hopefully will take care of. Only once this happened, the Metal can be a real competitor to the Verni Thor. So that's all from our side. If there are any questions left, please drop a comment. More information and the link to the shop can be found in the video description. If you like what we are doing here at CMM, please support us with a visit at chinamobilemag.de or at our English site chinadevices.net and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching. Bye bye, over and out.